Hello everybody, I'm some guy named Nate. You guys are watching Nickelodeon Kart Racers 3 Slime Speedway. We are doing the Grand Prix on medium difficulty again, and we are just getting our butts kicked because of this bullcrap, the XJ9 Cup, but we are in the Cowabunga Cup, starring Mikey himself. And in this part we're going to be Cindy Vortex, because we unlocked her from Jimmy Neutron. Actually, those stats are pretty decent. I'm just going to keep her in this. Also, it was really easy for them to put Cindy in here, because Sandy Cheeks from SpongeBob is the same voice actress. So it was really easy. They just said, hey, do some Cindy Vortex lines. And then they were like, she was like, okay. We are in the Turtle Lair. 2-for-1 pizzas, Vince. 2-for-1. Okay, and Leo's right there, so that's fine. I think I unlocked Leo, Raph, and then alternate costume, Raph. Also, a whole bunch of the voice actors for Jimmy Neutron are trying to get it to come back. They're trying to reboot it. Which, the show was good, but I don't think it was that good. It was very much a product of the early 2000s. Also, I know where the freaking shortcut is in this level, but I'm gonna miss it. I know it. There it is. Okay, we're gonna get my Mouser Bots. And looks like Squidina already got one of the challenges. And I accidentally honked the horn there. And I'm in third place somehow. And she does not want to do slime stunts. This is weird. And Cora just... Is that Cora? No, Zuko. 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 Took two of my shits. And we're taking the shortcut again, everybody. Or the long cut? I don't know what the hell this is. Shit. Damn it. Ah. What happened there? Oh my god. Bologna. Now I'm all the way in third. Cindy, you're ruining me. And I immediately hit a gnome. God dang it. Yeah, the gnome power-up is probably the shittiest one. There we go, we're back to normal. And I'm not gonna take that long cut this time. I'm just gonna see what happens if I go normal. Boom, I finally got that one. Okay, hopefully... And across the line. Good, holy crap. Cindy, you were gonna ruin it for me. Good thing you didn't. Also, I totally didn't vent about the thing I was gonna vent about, but we don't need to vent. The no vent situation. The double dare obstacle course. At least Cindy looks decent in 3D because her cartoon was in 3D, so that's fine. I like her horn though. Carl Weezer should have been in this. Didn't get a boost right out the gate yet. There we fucking go. Oh, bullshit. Hey, somebody else opened it for me. Good. That audience sucks. Yeah, you can't really control the carts on normal difficulty, so... Twinita! There we go. And Cindy won't shut the hell up about that generator. I don't even know what she's saying. It's fine. Does this work? Oh, that sucks. Okay, somebody else keeps opening it. So, everybody, the only way to open that shortcut is by hitting it with something. And I keep not getting attack power-ups because I'm freaking... There you go. Oh, crap. That didn't hit anybody. It's fine though. We have no choice. Dance towards that banana peel. I also didn't realize that that was the big gnome, not the little gnome. I was actually able to use my power up with a blue slime moment. And yes, I keep taking this slime shortcut. And I crash. And I keep clipping into the geometry on the floor in those little parts. It's so weird. Don't know what you want to play tonight. Are you going to play something for just for fun, or are you going to stream something? That's the real question. And right now, at this moment, I'm trying to figure out what I want to stream and what I want to play for fun, because those are... Oh, just fun? Well, what's in your to-beat pile that seems short that you just want to chip away at? It's probably going to be better than Crashing Drive 2. Fill the slime bar and get 3 blue sparks. I don't think that's gonna happen. Fuck. I'm moving to the head of the pack. And Korra's catching. Korra and Zuko just smashed me there. Ooh, a 1947 Van de Graaff electrostatic generator. Okay, there's one bar fill. I missed all those coins. Okay, good. I did get the fill your shit 3 times. That was insane. We have no choice. Also, I'm outrunning that ball. And the AI never does blue sparks. They probably will on higher difficulties, but I seem pretty safe to not go for that challenge. And I'll look at your thing in a second, Vince. I'm sorry. I'm just focused. Oh God. And of course I lost all my shit. Yeah, I can do a yellow boost no problem on this map. Good luck doing the blue boost. Yeah, the filling the slime meter 3 times challenge was really easy in this mission. Or this track, sorry. And we'll take a different route. And cross the line. Cool. Right now, only streams or co-ops. Okay. Well, honestly, I mean, you could do a random number generator. You can do something retro. Do something multiplayer-y. Multiplayer is always a jam. Alright, the New York rooftops. This is probably the most annoying track of the Ninja Turtles tracks. Do 9 tokens and do 5 stunts. I think I can do that. Especially because I already did 3 stunts. Nice turbo, nerd track. 4 stunts. 5 stunts. Oh, how did Prince Zuko do that? He already won that one. Shit. But yeah, for no reason in this track. Oh my god! Sorry. I'm gonna freaking. I'll check in a second, Vince. I really don't like this track just for that one little part. And yes, I know the secret power or shortcut is right there. We're gonna keep it spicy for the relationship for now. And frickin', is that Korra? She took my shit, Korra! I unlocked you and this is how you repay me? Okay, let's see. Only 2 things are Gas Station Sim and Tropico 6. So it's got lights and beeps. My dishwasher does that. Like so it looks like Zuko won both challenges somehow. And now I'm stuck. Go Cindy, go. What the fuck was that? Now we got Powder Toast Man, which is gonna make everybody with Powder Toast powers. So I'm definitely gonna miss the shortcut here. Oh crap, I got it! I'll take the left route this time, see if that is any better. Hopefully someone falls into that. What the f- that keeps happening! Also my geometry was stretched when I was getting revived, did you see that shit? See if I can hit the shortcut again. Good. It's way easier to hit the shortcut when you're not going 800 miles an hour. And it's easier when you're not bouncing up a freaking storm. And across the line. Ow, my leg. This should be fine. Yeah, we'll probably be at 2.5 hours for this stream, guys. Just because then I could beat 100. Say I beat 100cc because I just have 2. Wait, was that 2 left or was that the first one? That was the first one. God, I'm tripping. And you can't skip these. 2 different avatars in the same room and a scientist karate girl. Hopefully I unlocked another character, because now I'm out of characters. We'll see. Oh, and of course I got none of the bonus challenges that they don't tell you until the end, so no extra coins for me. My ass. Alright, how many coins do I have? 157? I can buy another character. Okay, I can only buy 5 characters. So I'll do Camp or SpongeBob. That'll be funny. Oh, wait, I can't. Oh, I have 150. So I can only do JoJo, Patrick, or Sandy. I'm going to buy Patrick. Yes.
No, this is Patrick.
Alright, we only have $7 to our name. So let's see how good this goes. Championship. Medium difficulty. The Krusty Canteen Cup. We get to be Patrick.
Patrick
in a cart. We're gonna go back to the boatmobile. I want something that lowers my handling. Okay, we're gonna stick with that, then we'll jump to... And then we'll go to Bold and Brash, and then that should do it. Hope it works. Come on, frickin' Patrick. Camp Coral's the first level. That's kind of why I wanted the camper SpongeBob for the next character, because I figured this would be next.
Here I go!
Patrick's got a funny horn, though. I can't believe I'm saying this, but famous internet YouTuber Mr. Enter, I totally agree with him when the movie Sponge on the Run shouldn't have been about what it was about, because the plot makes zero sense if you even know SpongeBob slightly. Because if you guys don't know, the plot of the third SpongeBob movie is King Poseidon, who shouldn't be confused with King Neptune, is kidnapping snails because he needs it for his beauty, so he's kidnapping the snails for their slime, I guess? And he's rubbing snails on his face. And the whole movie is basically a huge ad for Camp Coral, because for no reason, there's multiple flashbacks to SpongeBob when he's like, I remember when I first met Gary, I remember when I was in summer camp, and it just makes zero sense. Because they don't mention summer camp in the lore at all until this movie.
Bye-bye.
I am not able to effectively drift.
Whoa.
Rocco just flew past me, dude.
See ya.
Patrick is going 9 trillion miles an hour.
For me.
And I don't know how all these other characters are keeping up with Patrick. Like, I'm in a monster truck right now.
Yay! For me.
That's okay.
Here I go!
Yes, I heard them do that sound effect twice. Whoa!
Look at me go! Finland! Here goes...
Out of context, half the things Patrick is saying aren't funny unless you actually watch the episode.
This is
Fuck!
No!
Okay, ooh, I was close.
Yeah.
I was really close. Ren was right there. Shoot. And I got extra slime tokens for being Patrick. Look at him go. It's nuts, San Lorenzo Cruz. I just really want to beat this so I can play a few other PS5 games. Also, Patrick's fat is clipping through his chair. That's okay, though. They didn't really predict how the any card, any character thing would go. Because in the other games, you were linked to a cart, so your character would have one cart, and that was always their cart. And this was the first one of the big sales pitches was like, oh, it's the first Nickelodeon cart game where you can customize your vehicle, which is kind of cool. But half the time, this shit like this happens. Oh my god. Holy shit. That was awful. I don't know if you guys saw that, but I got it on recording. Clipping through the geometry and... That's okay. I'm in the lead magically after all that crap. That's amazing when you can clip through the geometry in any video game. Damn it, and my slime meter's almost full. Ultimate shortcut through the map. Yeah, I fell literally through the whole racetrack. They should give me the gold medal. It would have been funnier if clipping through the geometry like that would have caused me to beat the race. Also, I didn't notice that Patrick got both of the challenges. Look, on the side. Good job, Patrick. I need to do the speedway. More of this bullshit, but that's okay. We can salvage it. Oh, we salvaged it. Yeah, you cannot hit the brakes or drift when you're in this mode. It disables that. It's so stupid. It's like the bus from Speed. Last lap, baby.
Let's go faster.
I might keep streaming, though. I know Muff Jedi was streaming, and he said he owed me a solid and said he was going to raid my stream. So that'd be cool.
Tasty. Let's do this. Let's do this. Ooh, icky. Watch your step.
Crap. Most never fall through with mutual raids, yeah. That's true. I just like raiding whoever's online because I'm a homie and homies help homies. Even if it's just you and I are the only viewers, it still helps them a little bit, so I feel like it helps.
Does this look dangerous?
And across the line. Oh yeah. Okay, we're halfway through the Patrick Cup, so that's something. Go to the next one. And we still can't unlock any more characters, so for the next part, guys, for the last part of 100cc, we might end up just repeating the characters I really liked playing as. So we'll find out. Hit opponents and do slime stunts. Let's see if I can get either of them before the AI do. Damn it. Also, there's a bronze trophy in this game if you play an online race with a friend, but like the hell that's gonna happen. My friends aren't gonna buy this game. Friggin' Atlantis coin, dude. Friggin' Atlantis Morissette. Also, I'm holding the gas pedal. There we go.
Is this solid chocolate? Take this! That was so exciting!
I'm at 3-3, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to do stunts before everybody else does. Because that didn't count. And neither did that, even though I got a boost for it. Kind of poopy sometimes with how they award things, because I know the AI are going to get those two awards before I do.
Come out to play!
But that's alright. We're having fun here.
Does this look dangerous?
I thought that was a boost for a second. Also, it looks like Chucky got the award for doing stunts. Someone else is going to get the challenge for doing freaking hitting people. Because I just keep getting coins, which is fine, because I can upgrade my boosts.
Is it time for lunch?
Time to get a Krabby Patty, please.
Looks like Lincoln just got the other challenge, so it's pointless to do the challenges now. See, now he's doing stunts. Oh, now he didn't do a stunt on that one. I really hated challenge mode in 2, so I don't know if I'm gonna do challenge mode in this one. My neck is so stiff, guys. Probably gonna do a weird stretch after this episode. Not recorded, but still live stream me stretching.
Go faster. It's so pretty.
I like how half the coins are underwater. Well, this is a SpongeBob level. It's technically goo. And that was bullshit. Patrick, are you okay? Finland!
Look at me go! Oh boy!
Not bad.
Look at me go!
See, look at me go is also a funny phrase. Freaking love it.
Watch your step!
And across the line. Alright. Ugh. Ugh. That helped a little bit. Still feel a twang though. Okay, final race of this track, or this cup. We got this. The Royal Woods Rally. Okay, neck is still hurting. Even after that crunch. I think I have a nerve pinched or something. I gotta do some funkiness. But yeah, guys, I got a big list of crap on my 4 days of streams. And I'm going to try to plan even days that I work the day after, like tomorrow. I'm going to try to still stream because it's kind of unfair to my viewers and to me. Especially if I'm not playing video games and I'm not having fun. Even though on days I work, even though I'm not doing anything really physical, I still feel like crap because I'm like, yeah, wow, I did work today. Oh shit, an invisible walled man. I couldn't do that shortcut, that's fine.
This is more dangerous.
It's okay, we're gonna do the shortcut next part. For next lap.
Finland! I love you.
Oh, I love you.
Come on out, buddy!
Whoa!
Let's do this!
Yeah, this has to be the Garfield level. I know I said that the last time I played this mission, but...
Cold power! Oh, boy!
There we go.
Oh, look out!
Damn it. I think the watermelon is probably the worst power-up. It's like thunder. Yeah, that's actual bullshit with the AI getting my power up when I get my power up. I might lower my score on this if that really like makes the game way shittier later on, but we'll find out when we find out. Think you're gonna stop me? I still got my shortcut, baby. And now Patrick got that challenge and I hit a boat. I hit 2 boats. Okay, hopefully I can get this.
Here I go, here I go, here I go!
Come on, Patrick. There we go.
Yeah!
Woo! Well, now Patrick fell asleep. Well, we woke up, we're good. Good job, Patrick. I hope that there's alternate costumes, because then we could be Patrick Starshow Patrick when he's actually wearing a shirt. That's okay. There's Zuko. He got third, and he's firebending up a storm. SpongeBob got second.
I'm SpongeBob.
And ironically enough, the big Pat himself got first place. He's going to play his belly drum. Well, good job, Patrick. He did a good job. And look, he three-starred it. Alright, that's another YouTube part, so that's good. And of course I got none of the bonus challenges. Of course I didn't. Sucks. Alright, everybody, on the next installment of Nickelodeon Car Racer 3 Slime Speedway, we're going to wrap up 100cc, and then we'll see what happens from there. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to see you on the next Speedy Neckbreaker.